Morning students, today we are going to see the topic is LCM. Already in previous classes we have learned about HCF and rank back precision method and all we have learned. Today we are going to see LCM. You already known this topic. LCM means what? Least common multiples. You are already known because we have learned in previous classes. Okay, now we are going to solve the problems in this exercise 4.5. So first question is, we have to solve, find out the LCM given number by the prime factorization method. First prime factorization method. Okay, in this also we are going to do two method, prime factorization method and division method. Okay, now prime factorization method means two number is given for LCM, you have to find out the prime factors for each one of the given number. Okay, so separately you take both of the number and find out the prime factors. Okay, now I am going to work for 28 first. Prime factorization, you know, already start from the small number. I started with 2. So when you are dividing by 2, it is coming 12, 14. So again we are dividing by 2, 7. So these are all the prime factor of 28. Next, I am dividing by 2, so 49 is coming and 7 sevens are 49, so it's also over. So now let us write the prime factors of 28 first. 2 into 2 into 7. So I have written 98. 2 into 7 into 7. Okay. Next, LCM of 28 and 98 is equal to, what we have to do is, listen. Only when after writing the prime factors of the number, we have to look at the prime factors where it is maximum. Okay, so here also 2 is there, here also 2 is there, but where is the maximum? Here is the maximum, because 2 is having 2 times, here 2 times 2 number is having. So I take out these 2. After that 7 one number is there, but here only 1 is there, here 2 is there. If you are taking any number in this prime factorization method, where it is the maximum, that we need to take. So here 2 times is maximum, I take and written 2 times, and here also 2 times is maximum, 2 times I have written. So here any other number is not there. Yes, no number anymore. So only 2 and 7 I have completed. So multiply and write. 2 to 7, 4, 4, 7, 7, 28. 28, 7, 7, 196. That is the answer. Next, in that third question, 108, 135, 162. Next. Third question, 108, 135, 162. Okay. So here also what we are going to do, prime factorization method. One by one number, separately we are going to do the prime factorization and we are going to write the factors, prime factors. So now first, 108. First, let us start with 2. When I am dividing by 2, 54 is coming. Again, when I am dividing by 2, 27 is coming. We cannot divide it by 2. Here anymore, okay. So again, next number 3. 3, when I am dividing by 3, 9, 3 is 27, so 3, 3 is 9. So these are all the prime factors. Next, 135. 135 will not divide by 2, so let us start with 3. When I am dividing by 3, 45 is coming. Next one, I am dividing by 3 again, 15 is coming again. So 3, 5 is 15. Here 162. So this is an even number. Let us start with 2. When I am dividing by 2, 81 is coming. Next 3. 3. 27 is coming. When I am dividing by 3 again, 9 is coming. Again when I am dividing by 3, 3 threes are 9. So let us write the prime factors of the numbers separately. 108. So 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 3. So I have written 135. 3 into 3 into 3 into 5. So they are at 162. 2 multiplied by 3, multiplied by 3, multiplied by 3, multiplied by 3. Okay. Now, what are all the numbers present here 2, 3, 5. These three numbers only present. Let us see where it is maximum, right? So in first one, 2 is 2 times. Here, no 2. Here, only 1 time. So let us take the maximum 2 into 2.
Any understand?
Next, 3. Look at the 3. Here, 3 times is there. Here, 3 times is coming. Here, only 4 times. So let us take 4 times. That is maximum. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8. Next, any number is there? Yes, 5 is available. It is only present in 1 time, that is also 1 time. So no problem. Only it is maximum. I will put 5. Don't leave any number. If it is coming only 1 time, you can write 1 time. Okay? So now you multiply and write, the answer will be 1620. Okay? This is prime factorization method of finding LCM. Next method, division method. Okay? Division method means second problem. See here, find the LCM given number by division method. Okay. So division method, first one I have taken 480 and 672. Division method means how you are finding out the prime factorization method for each number. No? Here, by division method, we can write both numbers together. If they are asking for LCM 3 number or 4 number, we need to write both it together. Okay. Now, only 2 number we need to find out. I am going to find 2 numbers. Totally we are going to find out the division method. So, let us start with the smaller number. I have started with 2. Yes? So, 1 by 1 number we are going to divide and write. When I am dividing by 2, 240 and 336 is coming. Again, dividing by 2, 120, 168 is coming. So, again, I am going to divide by 2, 60, 84 is coming. Again, I am dividing by 2 because still it is even number. So, 32 is 60, 42 is 84. Again, 2. 15 is 30, 21. So, hereafter, 15 and 21, what happened? It's given add number. So, we cannot divide by 2 anymore. So, I am taking 3. So, 5 is 15, 7, 3 is 21. Okay. Next, it will not divide by 3. So, only 5 I am taking, 5 ones are 5. 7 will not divide. So, write the 7 again. Okay. Now, 7 ones are 7. So, LCM of 480 and 672 is, you write all the numbers. Okay? So, 2 multiplied by 2, multiplied by 2, multiplied by 2, multiplied by 2. 5 times 2 is only. Next, 3 1 time, 5 1 time, 7 1 time. So, I have written all of this number. Now, just you multiply the numbers and write, this is the LCM of the given 2 numbers. Can you understand? Okay. Next, the same problem and fourth question. Here they are given 4 numbers and they are asking to find out the LCM. So, 4 numbers I have written 20, 36, 63, 77. Okay, as usual, let us start with 2. So, when I am dividing by 2, 10, 18. This number will not be divided by 2. Yes? In this case, we have to write the same number. If any one number is dividing by 2 also, you can take 2. Okay? Remaining number we should write the same. So, 10, 18, these two numbers I am writing same. Again, by 2, dividing by 2. 5 is 10, 9 is 18, 63, 37, same. Next, you will not divide by 2. All numbers are add numbers. Right? Next, we will take next number 3. So, 5 will not divide by 3, so same, 3 3 is 9, 21, 2 3 is 6 and 1 3 is 3, so 21 is divided by 3, 77 will not divide, so 77 same. Be very careful, don't leave any number, very, you have to do properly, okay. If you are missing any one number also, the answer will be wrong, okay. So, next, here we got 21 and 77, right? Next again we are going to divide by 3 because 13 is there, 21 also there. So 5, 10, 3 ones are 3, 7 3 are 21, 77. Next, this number will not divide by 3, but 5 is there. Next number 5 is there, so I have taken 5, 5 ones are 5, 1 again, 7 again, 77 again. Okay, you have to go by increasing, okay, smaller to bigger. So 5 is over, next 7 and 77 is there, it will be divisible by 7. So 7 I am taking, 1 and 8, 7 ones are 7. Okay, next 11, 11 sevens are 77. Next only 11 is remaining, so 11 I take it, this is also prime number. So 1, 1, 1. When you are finding out the LCM by division method, the last step, okay, last step should be 1. Okay, the last step, last number will be 1. So until that we should divide. Okay, so I have divided. So LCM of 20, 36, 63 and 77 are 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 7 and multiplied by 11. If you are multiplying and checking the answer will be 13,860. Okay, so this is the division method. So we learn already prime factorization method and division method also. Okay, let us see the third problem and fifth problem. Okay students, let us solve third and fifth problem. Okay, so what is the third problem? Find the least number which when increased by exactly 15 is exactly divisible by 15 and 35 and 40. Least number is given, so least common multiple is LCM. So we need to find out the LCM first for these three number. Let us see the division method I will do now. Okay, so the least number we will take 2 first, so 15 will not divide, 35 will not divide, 24. Again we will divide by 2, 15, 35 again, this is 12, 12 is 24. So again 2, 15, 35, 6, 2 is 12. Again we will divide by 2, so 15, 35, 3, 3 2s are 6. Now let us take the next number 3. So we divide by 3, 5 3s are 15. How much? 33 will not be divided, so 1. 3 1s are 3. Again next 5. 5 1s are 5, 7, 5 is 35, 1. Next 7 1s are, okay, 1 already, 7 1s are 1. 7, 1. Okay, so we have written what are all the prime factors. Let us write LCM of 15, 35 and 48. So write it 4 times, 2 by 2, 2 by 2, 2 by 2 into 3 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 7. So when you are multiplying this number, the answer is coming 1680 according to the condition the required numbers will be 15. Therefore, the required number is 1680 minus 15. So that answer is 1665. Okay, so after finding the LCM, we need to subtract this 15, then we will get the answer. Next, fifth question. There only one thing is different. See here, find the least number. So there also we need to find out the LCM of these four number. Okay, next it is leaves a remainder. In this case, what we are done, when we are adding 15, we got the answer. So after that, when we are getting the answer, we subtracted this. But there, it will remains remainder. How much? 3. So let us see how to solve that. First, as you should find out the LCM of the given number. So 24, 36, 45, 54. So let us start with 2, 12, 18, 45 same and 27. Next, 2 again, 6 to the 12, 9 to the 18, 45 is same again and 27 is same again. Okay. Let us do one more time, 2. So 3 to the 6, 9, 45, 27. This will not be there. Next, number 3. 1. 3 threes are 9. 15 threes are 45. 9 threes are 27. Next, again 2. 1. 3 ones are 3. 5. 3. Let us do again by 3. 1. 1. 5 the same. 1. You understand 5? So 5 also 5, 1. I told you already, until getting 1 in the last step, we have to do the division. Okay? So for your understanding only, I am doing directly. Okay? So the number is, you have find out the prime factor. So write the LCM of 24, 36, 45. And 54. So write one by one, 1, 2, 3 times. Next, 3 also 3 times. Next, 5. So when we are multiplying and writing this, answer is 1080. So this is the LCM. So how can we find out the required number? In this problem, the required number is leaving remainder 3 when we are dividing. Okay, so now it is exactly divisible by this number. So we need remainder means what? Yes, just this number is getting 3 more means when we are dividing. Now it is exactly divisible with remainder 0. Okay, so remainder is coming means just we need to add that number. Okay, so take your number. Well, is equal to 1080 plus 3. So answer is 1083. Okay, can you understand? Okay, students. So today we are learn LCM. In that LCM, two methods. How we have to find out by the prime factorization method and division method. So these are all the model we are seeing today. So remaining problem let us see in the next class. If you have any doubts in these classes, if you are not understand means, so nowadays I am every day available in our school. So morning 10 o'clock to 1 o'clock, 1 p.m. I will be available in the classes. So if you have any doubt, anyone can come and ask your doubts to me directly. Okay, instead of doing any messages in the group or asking in the group, if you are coming directly, it is easy to explain you also. Okay, I hope you are understand. So what are all the homework? In first question 2 and 4, second question 2 and 3, and after that 4 and 6 is the homework problem. Okay. Thank you, student. Thank you for your attention. Thank you. Have a nice day.